While we quickly got you here, like, may as well ask you about the UFO incident. You were mentioning it to us before, but yeah, just briefly go over that one again if you can.
Yeah. Same area. It was Dunbogan, Camden Head region. For those of us that grew up around there that would know where I'm talking about.
What year?
Oh, shit, now you're asking. probably about
1993.
Alright. Anyway, so go on with the story. Yeah. A mate of mine, Pagey, another Jace, we were pulled up on the riverbank at this place. It's on Bogan Camden Head. And, yeah, we were pulled up on this riverbank, Dunbogan Camden Head. And, again, a little bit high, had a joint, and we were just kicking back, sitting in the car. And just staring stoned out the windscreen and watching what we thought was a satellite tracking across the sky, just like this bright star. I'm sure you've all seen satellites track across the sky. And yeah, then it just suddenly started, bang, sudden movement, like whoosh, this way, then stop. And then, whoosh, 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 like, all over the place, like, for about maybe 2 or 3 minutes, just bouncing around, like, pausing for, like, 5, 10, 15 seconds here and there, and then bouncing, and then just went, and just, like, a little pinpoint of light that just disappeared into and that was it. And again, like, did the whole, did you fucking see that shit, like, oh, yeah, really, like, cause fuck, I saw that shit, and I was like, yeah, fuck man, like, you know, like, it was real. So like,
how many witnesses was it? Just three or two?
Stoners going,
it's three of yous?
Three of us with the Yowie, and just Pagey and myself with the
right,
whatever that was. I don't know if it was a UFO, I don't know what it was, man, but it fucking bounced around, it didn't just go, wasn't a satellite, that's for sure.
I was going to ask one more question. I know, like, you know, some people might think this is a touchy topic, but do you think possibly even, you know, the fact that you'd been taking some sort of, you'd been smoking and you'd had some sort of mind-altering experience, perhaps that altered your perceptions in a way that opened you up to other frequencies or something that you might not have perceived otherwise or something? Possibly. Yeah, because in both of these occasions that this happened.
Yeah, well, both times we were stoned, definitely, like, you know, possibly.
In that case, you know, like a lot of other people who, you know, have experiences like this.
A lot of old people like say it's a gateway drug, mate. Maybe it's a gateway to a different place
that's that they're
not thinking about.
And a lot of stories would be disregarded by, you know, a lot of people because there is a mind-altering substance that's come into the equation.
So it's easy to dismiss and disregard. But
yeah, there's definitely more to be studied in this field one way or another. Terence McKenna often talks about, you know, the idea of UFOs been, you know, fairly commonplace amongst the drug taking communities. It's only amongst the clean cut establishment that they would be skeptical of these things because they've been conditioned otherwise. But interesting.
Very.
Well, thanks for time.
No worries.
Cool, guys. That's it.